The Untold Truth of Lily Singh. Indian-Canadian comedy vlogger Lily Singh ended 2016 as the richest female YouTuber on the planet, having raked in as much as $7.5 million from her channel, which has 12.6 million subscribers and counting, as well as her various other ventures. This made her the third highest paid YouTuber overall that year. Prankster Roman Atwood came second, while PewDiePie remained in the top spot, and she built on that success in 2017, with Forbes recently naming her the top influencer in the entertainment sector. Singh has come a long way from her first upload, a spoken word piece on religion and humanity watched by just 70 people, but she remembers the trials and tribulations of those early days very clearly. From her humble beginnings to her imminent mainstream breakthrough, this is the untold truth of Lily Singh. She has a degree in psychology. After graduating from York University with a bachelor's degree in psychology, Singh couldn't decide what to do with her life. She spent an entire year doing nothing as she tried to figure out what her next step should be, but walking an ordinary career path simply wasn't appealing to her. Her parents, both of Punjabi descent, insisted that she go back to school and study for a master's in counseling psychology, but she had an epiphany while filling out her application form. "I remember writing the application for my master's and then going, 'Oh my God. I don't even want to do these applications. How am I going to do this for 4 years?'" she told The Hindu. "It was during that time, between sending applications, that I decided on doing YouTube videos seriously, and I already had a few videos out at that time. At that moment, I walked up to my parents and was like, 'Hey, I've decided that I am not going to do my master's, and instead I am going to make YouTube videos.'" Her parents didn't get it. Singh's decision to go full-time on YouTube came as a shock to her parents, though after Superwoman, her online persona, became popular on the platform, they slowly started to come around to the idea. "When I first started, it was not that they were unsupportive, they just didn't get it, and that's fair," she told Flair. "Even my friends don't get YouTube right now. It took my relatives calling them saying, 'Is your daughter Superwoman?'" Her Punjabi heritage was a big part of her channel early on, and Singh regularly portrayed fictionalized versions of her mother and father in her videos, which they came to not only understand, but really enjoy. "Recently, I feel so grateful because they've become supportive in a new way," the YouTuber said. "They actually watch my videos and understand the art I'm doing. My mom really believes my message. My dad has watched all my videos and he knows how many subscribers I have at any given moment. He's obsessed. They understand what I'm trying to do, and that's really special to me." She didn't set out to become famous. Back when Singh started her channel in October 2010, fame and fortune were not words that people associated with YouTube. The platform had been around for a couple of years at that stage, and there were a few content creators that were well known among viewers, but the notion of the internet celebrity was still alien to most people, Singh included. The real reason she decided to become a YouTuber was actually to counter some mental health problems she'd been suffering. "When I started on YouTube, nobody knew that you could make a living off of YouTube," she told Elle Canada. "I started because I was sad and I wanted to be happy. And a lot of my peers who started around the same time, it was for the same reason. We were all messed up in some way. We had anxiety, we were loners, and we turned to YouTube. But now when people start YouTube, it's 'I want to be a YouTuber, I want a career, I want to make money, I want to be famous.' And it's much more of a business now." She didn't want her race to define her. While Singh used her South Asian roots as a source of humor in her content regularly to begin with, she never wanted her race to define her comedy, which was exactly what happened. "There were already so many females on YouTube, but I'm pretty sure I am the first Indian big YouTuber that's also female," Singh said. When I first started, all the media I ever got was, hey, there's this Indian girl, and even though she is Indian, she gets views and stuff. Before long, she realized that if she was ever going to shake that tag, she would have to make her content more universal. Earlier on, my videos used to be so geared towards Indian people because that's what I thought I had to do, she told AOL. So I would call my videos things like, my Indian parents do this or Indian girls this, and very quickly I realized that I didn't have to do that. All girls are pretty much the same and all parents are pretty much the same, so I stopped doing that and I stopped cornering myself into a niche that I thought I had to be in. She's a proud Canadian. On top of being extremely proud of her Punjabi heritage, Singh is also a flag-waving Canadian, and she has a particular love of the culturally diverse Toronto. Out of all the places I've been to, Toronto is the most multicultural, she told Noisy about her home city. If I'm walking around a shopping mall in the USA and I see a turban or a hijab, it's still a wow moment, but in Toronto, you never feel that. You take that multiculturalism for granted. In 2015, she teamed up with fellow Indo-Canadian YouTuber and rapper Humble the Poet for a song called I Vivi, Roman numerals, for 416, the area code serving Toronto, which celebrated the ethnic tapestry of the city. The video has been viewed more than 4 million times today and is just one of the reasons that Singh is held in such high regard by her fellow Canucks. You should look at my Twitter, how many tweets there are like, Canada's the best. She told CBC. When you're online and you see all these other Canadians cheering, you feel like you're part of something. Moving to LA was hard. She might be a proud Canadian, but every serious YouTuber eventually realizes that if they're going to make it big, they need to be in California. LA has become the unofficial YouTube capital, home to the majority of the website's top creators, including, as of December 2015, Lily Singh. Collaborations are a surefire way to widen your viewership, and the possibilities for team-ups in Los Angeles are endless, but being raised in a traditional Indian family meant Singh was woefully unprepared for living alone. We're only allowed to move out when you're married, so what I'm doing right now is a huge exception, she explained to Chelsea Handler, who couldn't believe that Singh didn't fly the nest until her mid-20s. I realized how useless I actually am, because it's true, Indian parents do everything for you, she continued. I was like, how do I use this laundry machine, or this dryer? I was so clueless of what to do, I got to my apartment and I had no toilet paper. I used Chipotle napkins for like a really long time. She's collaborated with mainstream selfs. When Singh landed in LA, she was met by fellow YouTuber Swoozy, who has a sizable fanbase of his own with over 5 million subscribers, but is far from the most famous person Singh has collaborated with. The previous December, she made a video with fellow Canadian comic Seth Rogen and his BFF, James Franco, which was set up by YouTube. They wanted to promote their new movie, and they chose to do that through popular YouTube channels, Singh told BuzzFeed. I submitted my idea for a collab, and fortunately I was selected. Her biggest celebrity collab to date has been with her childhood hero and adult crush, Dwayne Johnson. She met The Rock backstage at the 2015 MTV Movie Awards and despite freaking out more than a little, the two hit it off. They later made a video in which the former professional wrestler asks Superwoman for advice on starting his own YouTube channel, which has been viewed over 13 million times. It was super cool, it was the first video on his channel and he collaborated for a video on my channel, Singh told The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon. It was like, let me teach you how to be YouTube star, but really I'm just hitting on him the whole time. She's best friends with Charlize Theron. Arguably the most famous of Singh's famous friends, South African actress Charlize Theron wound up becoming besties with her after they met at a charity event. I went to a dinner with her to discuss all the amazing work she does, seen revealed during her appearance on Chelsea Handler's Netflix talk show. I was randomly in Italy once for some Google stuff and she was right beside me and I was like, Charlize. And we became best friends. I love her. They plan to go on an African safari with a bunch of Turan's friends, Handler included. The pair have been very open about their admiration for one another, both online and in public. Singh told Turan that she amazed her on Twitter and the Atomic Blonde star replied by saying she was in awe of the vlogger. The two even shared a kiss at a recent event celebrating 10 years of Turan's African Outreach charity, which teaches young men and women about the dangers of HIV and AIDS, a problem that sadly remains widespread in parts of Africa. Transitioning into the mainstream has been tricky. Despite her ever-growing pool of A-list friends, Singh has still found it hard to make the transition into mainstream Hollywood herself, as she explained to the BBC. I can go to my premiere at the Chinese theatre and everyone will know me and everyone will cater to me, she said, referring to the opening of a trip to Unicorn Island, a 2016 documentary about her 27-city world tour. And then I'll go to an audition and get rejected left, right, and center. They don't watch my videos and they don't really know who I am. It's easy to assume that being internet famous automatically gives you a head start on other aspiring actors, but Singh is living proof that this simply isn't the case. It is like starting from scratch when it comes to traditional Hollywood, she continued. In the digital space, people consider me a star, but then I go into auditions and they'll be like, sorry, what was your name again? I feel like I'm living this split life, trying to climb two different ladders and I'm on very different rungs on each ladder. But her big break isn't far away. If there's one trait that Singh has in abundance, it's persistence. She learned quickly to take rejection in her stride and keep on chipping away at the wall between the digital and traditional space, which is slowly starting to pay off for her. She voiced a pair of unicorns named Misty and Bubbles in 2016's Ice Age Collision Course and also won the small part of Kathy in Bad Moms that same year, which led to stars Millikens, Kristen Bell and Catherine Hahn appearing on Singh's channel to answer her questions about motherhood. She appeared alongside fellow transitioning YouTube stars Memory Hart and Grace Helbig in 2017 TV movie The Confessional, but according to her in profile she only has a single feature in the pipeline for 2018, an adaptation of Ray Bradbury's dystopian novel Fahrenheit 451. This is more than likely because she's been busy writing and promoting her new book, How to Be a Boss, A Guide to Conquering Life. Boss is very much associated with the workplace. You think of a boss at work that you answer to, she told Elle Canada. A boss is not restricted to the workplace. It's like a lifestyle. It's your personal life, how you communicate, how you hustle. Every facet of you, if you do it to the best of your ability, you do it like a boss. The book became a New York Times number one bestseller. She's a UNICEF Goodwill Ambassador. Singh is no stranger to humanitarian work. In 2016 she teamed up with social enterprise MeetAWe to launch the Girl Love Bracelet, with the idea being to use all the proceeds made from the sales to help young Kenyan girls get an education. The following year, UNICEF decided to honor her by making her a Goodwill Ambassador, a title held by numerous A-list celebs including David Beckham, Jackie Chan, and Shakira. Lily Singh is already a superwoman helping empower girls around the world, and we are delighted that she will lend her passion and her powerful voice to speak up on behalf of the most vulnerable children, UNICEF Deputy Executive Director Justin Forsyth said. Yasmin Hakua, UNICEF's representative in India, was particularly thrilled about Singh coming aboard, calling her a role model to young girls worldwide. We look forward to the role she will play in generating greater discussion and greater action around the value of girls in India and everywhere, Hakua said. Needless to say, Singh was delighted with the news. I am honored to join UNICEF as a goodwill ambassador and to use my voice to support its mission of reaching every child, she said at a special event in New Delhi. The children I have met here are overcoming so many challenges and they are living proof of what a child can achieve if given a chance. She's also a staunch feminist. While promoting her book, Singh gave a number of interviews and discussed a number of different topics, but one that came up when she sat down for a chat with Glamour was feminism. The women's magazine asked her about the response she received after posting a video that explained why she didn't need a man in her life to be happy, which apparently incensed a number of her male viewers. One of the most controversial things I've ever said was that I'm a feminist, she said. To this day, any time I talk about anything related to women's issues, it's probably the most backlash I receive. I think there's still a certain level of intimidation and confusion that comes around a strong female voice. That video is a prime example of it. There were a lot of angry guys in those comments. She was accused of being a man hater, but nothing could be further from the truth, according to Singh. Feminism is the fight for equality for both sexes, not just women, she said in a blog post on her official website. So yes, I can proudly say I am a feminist. That being said, I also believe in many other causes that have nothing to do with gender equality,